Hi everyone. The program will begin at 3 o'clock. If you have any queries, be open to use the chat box. You can type your questions there. The beautiful thing about learning is that no one can take away from you. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the webinar on the topic Digital Image Processing, conducted by the Department of Vocation, Information Technology, CMS College, Kottayam, as a part of our technical event, TechShetra. To give the instruction to all the participants of the webinar, I invite Juby.
Good evening all. There are some instructions. All participants are requested to mute audio and disable video while joining. If you have any queries or doubt, post it on the chat box with your name and mention whether you are a student. Your query will be answered during the question and answer section at the end of the webinar. Request for feedback form during the session will not be entertained. Feedback form will be provided at the end of the webinar, so please stay tuned. And e-certificate only provided those who have submitted the feedback form. So it is compulsory to fill the feedback at the end of the webinar. Thank you. All the best.
A smile is the user. I spin the eyes to the best.
Hi, greetings to one and all. I'm Subin. It gives me an immense pleasure to grace all of your presence in the webinar on digital image processing conducted by the Department of Vocation, Information Technology at CMS College, Kottayam, as a part of our technical event, TechShetra. And it gives me a tremendous contentment to be presenting the welcome speech. So first of all, I welcome the principal of CMS College, Kottayam, Dr. Varghese C. Joshua. Sir, welcome to this webinar. And I would love to welcome our honorable guest and the speaker of today's session, Dr. Gina Varghese, the assistant professor of Amaljyoti Engineering College, Kanyarapalli. She has worked as an assistant professor in Vishwajyoti College of Engineering and Technology at Varakulam. And she achieved a PhD in Computer Science and Engineering from Mahatma Gandhi University in 2019. And she had honored with the UGC Maulana Azad Scholarship for her PhD in 2019. A very sincere warm welcome, ma'am, to this webinar. And then I welcome our beloved head of the department, Mrs. Rashmi Charyan. She is the teacher coordinator of this webinar. And she is very inspiration, and she gives us a lot of support to do this event to make it a huge success. So welcome, ma'am, to this webinar. And next, I also welcome all the faculties and the teachers to this event. And I would like to welcome the student coordinators of the program, Mr. Sebastian Raju and Mr. Sharath Ramesh. And finally, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to all of you committed to this event to make it a huge success. You know, this event would have been impossible without the support of each and everyone present here. So I'm sure this program will be profitable and it will be fruitful for everyone present here. So once again, a sincere warm welcome to everyone to this webinar on digital image processing conducted by the Department of Vocation, Information Technology of CMS College, Kottayam, as a part of TechShetra. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you, Subin. Now, I call upon our honorable guest, Dr. Gina Varghese, Assistant Professor, Amaljyoti Engineering College, Kanyarapalli, to present on the topic digital image processing.
Good afternoon, all of you. Am I audible?
Yes, please, audible.
Okay, thank you. I'm so delighted to be here, to be the part of your tech event, Tech Kshetra. And I'm so happy that you are invited me for this webinar. And thanks to the college management and the department of BWOC, especially to Ms. Vishnu Charya for inviting me to have a speak in this webinar. Thank you so much. And I'm happy that this topic, digital image processing, is now a very interesting topic. And many researchers are working on this area. So without much introduction, I'm planning to get into the topic. So can I proceed? If there is any disturbances, you just pop up messages and you can ask me questions at any time. And I'm sorry, as per the role of this webinar, you pop up the questions at the end. So let me just share my screen. If it is not visible, please inform me. So can I see my slide, please? Excuse me, can you see my slide? Can you see my slide? I'm sorry, I'm not, I can't hear anything.
Yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So digital image processing, this is a wonderful area in this era because everything are processed and all things are in image forming nowadays. So this digital image processing is a really wonderful topic in this world, in this era now. So we are all familiar with image processing techniques. When we used to take a picture in our camera, in our mobile phone, we used to do many operations on those pictures. So the basic work or the basic technology behind all those operations are digital image processing only. We used to take photos, we used to take videos, we used to enhance the brightness of the images, we used to do cropping, we used to resize the images, we used to do other contrast stretching, etc. So all these things, the basic technology behind all these things is digital image processing. So you can see, as you can see in my slide, all these images, like the image of a retina, the movement of a person, that the X-ray images, the fingerprint images, palm images, all this we are familiar with, right? So digital image processing deals with all these things. Okay, so before continuing this slide, I will just show you one video. Okay, just see this video. So I think you have seen the video and you understood the major application areas where we work on, where we use this image processing techniques, isn't it? Okay. So an image, what is an image? An image can speak loud than words. See here, I will show you an image. This is an image taken by typing the keyword image in Google. So when I type the keyword image in Google, I got this many images. So this, each of this image has its own story. So the first image is the image of a highway with an overbridge. A person is taking a photo of that overbridge with a camera in his hand, and there are no other workers on the road. All these informations can be extracted by seeing just that image. So we can understand that there is an overbridge, there is a camera, there is a person who is standing in the middle of that road. It is a highway. So these informations I got without reading any word. So that's what I am saying.